As you can see here, I'm only holding the striker about a 16th of an inch up off the ferro rod. This allows me to use minimal amounts of pressure to produce gobs and gobs of sparks off of these ferro rods. More so, it's the striker that makes the ferro rod, not the other way around. In our case, our ferro rods are a fine combination of soft and hard metals, which allows for real hot dancing sparks, as you see here. Now, my ferro rods come out real nice and smooth because I use only the 16th of an inch and real even pressure when I strike them. Here's an example. It's real smooth. Here's an example of one that I really was rough on. Those speed bumps or ridges are made from holding the striker too far up and uneven pressure when I strike them. That's when I'm really laying into them like that. That's what happens. You'll have to fix that with sandpaper. Now back onto the show.